Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'm Dr. Asim from Pathology Department. Today we'll discuss about the thyroid disorders like hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. There are many other conditions which are like autoimmune thyroiditis, which will also be discussed in the next lectures. Basically, you must understand what are thyroid hormones and their metabolic functions. What are thyroid function tests and what they are ordered and how these tests are interpreted. Moreover, Graves' disease and its diagnosis will be discussed. The hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism, different conditions in these headings. And most importantly, the lab diagnosis and the hypothyroidism. These will be discussed in detail. The thyroid is divided by thin fibrous septa into lobules composed of about 20 to 40 evenly dispersed follicles. These are lined by cuboidal to columnar epithelium, which are filled by the PS positive thyroglobulin. This is colloid, and these are the follicular cells. This is the stroma. This is the thyroid follicle, normal one. And if you enlarge and focus on it, this is the thyroid follicle, which is lined by the cuboidal to columnar epithelium. And here, these are the parafollicular cells, which secrete calcitonin, which is involved in the calcium metabolism. Now, in normal thyroid gland, the production of the T3 and T4 is under the control of the thyroid stimulating hormone. Now, what happens due to its action? T4 and T3 are produced when there is action of the thyroid on the receptors of the follicular cells. Now, production of these two hormones, T3, T4, involves different steps involving the iodine trapping, thyroglobulin synthesis, incorporation of the iodine, coupling, storage, and excretion. These all steps you must have studied in the second year. And these headings must be in mind because we must know different levels of the deficiencies and the overproduction of the hormones. And sometimes there is a deficiency of some enzymes which lead to the non-proper production of thyroid hormones. T3 and T4. T4 is called thyroxine, and T3 is called triiodothyronine. These are the two names of the hormones which are produced by the thyroid gland. You see, the physiologically more potent is the T3. This you must remember. And if you focus on this chart, the more effective is the unbound component of the thyroid hormones, which are bound to the proteins. They are less potent, but these unbound are more important to measure because there may be some difference in the level of the binding proteins due to some diseases. And 0.3% of the total bound, 99.7% of the bound T3, just 0.3% is unbound. So it is very much active. In contrast to this, 99.7 of the T4, bound T4, 0.03% is unbound. The shorter half-life of the T3, it's a longer half-life. These differences must be in your mind. the TSH, which is released from the pituitary, it acts on the thyroid follicular cells. The binding of the TSH to its receptor on the thyroid follicular epithelium results in the changes and activation of the receptor. This activation of the G protein eventually results in an increase in the intracellular cyclic AMP, which stimulates the thyroid growth, hormone production and synthesis, and release of the cyclic AMP-dependent protein kinase. What is negative feedback? Negative feedback is when there is decreased level of T3 and T4, it stimulates the release of the TSH from the TRH from the hypothalamus, and then production of the TSH, which acts on the thyroid hormones and releases the formation, enhances the formation of the T3, T4. If the level are increased, then it reversibly acts on the decreased production of the TRH from the, and then decreased production of the TSH. This is called negative feedback. The functions of the thyroid hormones leads to the hypermetabolic state induced by excess thyroid hormone and to overactivity of the sympathetic nervous system. All these effects, control of the basal metabolic rate, effects on the growth, carbohydrate and fat metabolism, BMR and body weight, cardiovascular system, gastrointestinal system, and central nervous system, all these effects are magnified in patients with the hyperthyroidism and subdued in the patients with the hypothyroidism. Now, if you see the effects on different organs of the body, the thyroid hormone on brain, it leads to, if the levels are decreased, then there may be depression, decreased concentration, general lack of the interest. It may be due to the lack of the hormones. On heart, there are effects like decreased heart rate, increased blood pressure or decreased blood pressure, decreased cardiac output. Then on liver, there will be increased synthesis of the LDL, the production of the cholesterol, and elevated triglycerides. On intestine, there may be constipation or GI disturbances or decreased gastrointestinal activity. And on reproductive system, there may be decreased fertility, menstrual abnormalities, and may harm development of the infant. Now, basically, they are divided into two categories, hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism. These are the two disorders. Hyperthyroidism, it includes many diseases. In hypothyroidism, this is in the adults and in the children, which is called cretinism. About 200 million people worldwide have a thyroid disorder. These are the few facts about the thyroid diseases. It may be hyperthyroid or hypothyroid, which will be discussed. 30 million of the people are undiagnosed because of the symptoms, lesser symptoms, or maybe if it is not properly picked up and they remain undiagnosed. 80% of all the thyroid diseases are diagnosed in females. This is important to remember. 20% of the thyroid storm cases end in death. Thyroid storm is the crisis in which the increased level of the hormones, they may cause increased metabolic disturbances leading to the crisis. Then 80% of all thyroid diseases are diagnosed as hypothyroidism and 20% as hyperthyroidism. You must appreciate this difference when you are seeing the cases of the thyroid disorders. Although they will definitely show you the picture and the symptoms, but you must keep in mind that hypothyroidism is more common as compared to the hyperthyroidism. Females are 5 times more likely to develop a hypothyroid disease condition over males. 50% of the children with the parents have thyroid disorders and who may develop a thyroid disorder themselves by the age of 40%. It means the familial incidence is also prevalent in thyroid diseases. Now, what are the thyroid function tests? Thyroid stimulating hormone, free T4, free T3 are frequently ordered simultaneously as thyroid function tests. But we'll see when we will see the different charts that all three are not required to be ordered at one time. But routinely, it is said that thyroid function test completely ordered in form of TSH, free T4, and free T3. The choice of the thyroid function test has changed over the last 10 to 15 years. Previously, FT4 has been the most popular test, but now it is the TSH. Because sensitive methodology for the TSH are now developed, and so this method is preferred. It's the first line of the investigation in diagnosing hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. In most situations, TSH is the sole test of the thyroid function test. You can simply diagnose with one test, either it is hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism. It is the most sensitive test of the thyroid function test, and adding other tests is only of the value in specific circumstances and just to confirm and for the treatment purposes. In normal patients, when TSH is within the normal reference range, there is 99% likelihood that the FT4 will also be within the reference range. This must be kept in mind. So TSH is the most important test in diagnosing the thyroid disorders. So in next lecture, we'll discuss about hyperthyroidism with particular reference to the Graves' disease. Thank you very much.